It's time for the Family Feud. Introducing the Henze family, ready for action. And the Page family, on your marks. Let's start the Family Feud. With the star of Family Feud, Richard Dawson.
I'll accept that applause and welcome as my Christmas present. Christmas Eve, right now. I've got to start to do some shopping. I'd fall behind otherwise. Champs are right here, the Henzes. Whoop! You got a lot of money for Christmas shopping. How much have you won?
We've won $5,640.
Great! Yeah. We'll meet your family, please.
Okay. This is my oldest brother, Eric.
Richard.
My older sister, Kathleen.
Older sister. Everybody's older. Hi, Kathleen.
My older brother, John.
Hi, Richard. Hi, John.
And my oldest sister, Lisa.
Hello.
All those family. Is your voice starting to break, or do you have laryngitis?
Permanent.
Permanent?
It's always like this.
I didn't hear that on the last show.
No?
Not quite as pronounced.
Excited, I don't know.
I was like Wally and the Beaver.
Hi. Hi, Mrs. Cleaver.
Will you help me welcome the Pages? They're here to challenge you. Give them a big, big welcome. Hey, Henze, good to have you here. May I meet your family, please?
Okay. This is my sister, Kathy.
Welcome, Kathy.
My sister, Shelley.
Hi, Richard.
My mother, Noreen.
Hello, how do you Noreen. Do, Richard?
And my father, Jay.
Richard,
how do you good do? Good to have you here. Good looking family. And you live here in town?
Yes, I live in California, down close to San Diego.
Okay. But your family came in to be on the show?
Right. Yeah, they're from Utah.
From where?
Utah.
Well, where in Utah? Oh, it's a big place, huge. I've been there.
Well, some from Ogden, some from Clearfield, and some from Salt Lake.
Okay. Now, we've got to win some money then because they come
all the
way.
Oh, we do. We do.
Just want to give you a little pep talk.
Okay.
This is pretty.
Oh, Richard, we have a gift for you. We think families are forever,
did
and
you
we.
Make that?
We had it made for you, yes.
Okay, I'm pretty, yes, sir.
We just appreciate Family Feud and
that
all they do
gorgeous.
To promote good families in America.
Isn't that beautiful? Thank you. Thank you all. That's lovely. Ready to play it?
You bet.
Play the feud. Let's go. Come on. Good luck to both of you now. 100 people surveyed. Top 5 answers on the board. You got to try and get the most popular answer. Here's the question. Name something specific that parents might have to assemble on Christmas Eve.
A bicycle.
A bicycle. Number one. Can you play or pass?
We're going to play, Richard.
We're gonna play. Okay. Something specific that parents might have to assemble on Christmas Eve.
Let's say a toy wagon.
Okay.
A little wagon.
A wagon? Good job. Are you a parent? Are you a parent?
Yes.
That's
oh,
how
yes.
you move.
Thank you.
Nice to have you here.
Thank
Shelley.
You.
What do you think the parents might have to assemble on Christmas Eve?
How about some type of model, like a truck, you know, something?
Okay, because we want something truck. Specific.
Okay,
a truck.
We'll say
a truck? No.
Bad
only bad if it's not there. Well, I just not bad.
Welcome to you.
What would you say, Madonna Norman?
I'd like a dollhouse.
Okay. Any of our 100 people say a dollhouse?
Oh, I think
that. I look like a goodie. Jay, well, take a lucky lollipop. Let's change these strikes. We don't want them.
Oh.
This could be a goodie. Don't have faith in me now. Believe me. Something specific the parents might have to assemble on Christmas Eve.
Model train.
Okay, sir.
Good.
Sure.
Yeah.
Model train. Come on, Lindsay, let's keep this going.
I'm going to say, on the lines of train, how about a race car set?
All right. If it's there, okay, and if not, third strike, a race car set. Not there. $91 to unrevealed answer.
Swing set.
You ever done one of those? Oh, swing set gets you $91 if not Lindsay gets it. Swing set! You got it. Great! A tricycle, five. Artificial Christmas trees? I got mine finished March the 9th. We'll be back right after. People survey, top eight answers on the board. Here's the question. Name a country whose flag you would recognize.
Yeah. United States.
The United States. Number one. Do you play or pass?
We'll play.
Better play. Well done. Country whose flag you would recognize, Shelley?
I would say USSR.
Okay. USSR, Russia.
Great Britain.
Aha. The jolly old Union Jack, Great Britain. Well done. Jay?
Japan.
Japan. May we see Japan, please? You got it? Rising sun. Country's flag you would recognize.
Well, Richard, I'm going to say France.
Okay, France. Yeah. You got it. Well done.
How about China?
Say, China? No. Is that a red ball? Isn't it?
That's
Japan.
Japan?
What are you? China? Anyone know? It's all right. Is there a Chinese resident here who would just hold up their flag for a second? If not, please don't make a big thing of it.
How about Germany?
Ah, Germany.
Okay. Oh, no. Not getting up. Here. Well, I'm thinking of Switzerland.
Oh my, now you're here. Switzerland? No! $73, three flags yet to be revealed.
Mexico. We'll go with Canada.
Canada. A little north of the border gets you $73. If not a big lead for the pages, Canada. You got it. Six. Italy. Eight. And Israel. Yeah, I know that Eddie did know the flag of China, but you keep forgetting it, don't you? We'll be back right after. Don't you come back? $91.73. Let's go. 100 people surveyed, top six answers on the board. Here's the question. If there were such a thing as reincarnation, name an animal you'd like to come back as.
Yeah. A dog.
A dog. All right. Play or pass?
We're going to play. Thank you.
Okay. Dog. You realize you'll have to live with Lauren Green. How are you?
Fine, Richard. How are you doing?
Just saying. If there's such a thing as reincarnation, name an animal you'd like to come back as.
How about a bird?
Bird? Oh, you, of course. John's very famous with buying presents for birds. Bird! Yeah! Well done. Come on. Hi. Let's take our lucky lollipop.
Okay.
Come on, Lise.
Oh. It's a lucky one.
Wasn't the last one lucky for you? Sure. I mean, no. Look at all this money you've won. The second thing is reincarnation, name an animal you'd like to come back.
Well, they say cats have nine lives.
Yeah, they would be good.
So a cat.
Sure. A cat! What animal would you come back as?
How about a fish?
Fish.
Good answer, Jim.
Fish! You could end up with the main course.
How about a lion?
A lion!
Good answer.
I'm here to guide you through the eddies of life. Yes.
I'm going to go with a horse.
A horse? Wouldn't that be fun? Horse? Dog, John.
How about a tiger?
Tiger? If it's there, you got it all. If not. Second strike, a tiger? No.
I'm going to say a giraffe.
A giraffe. Great.
Never
see all the ball games. Never buy a ticket. Giraffe, you ever see the Michael Jackson concert? Be great. Giraffe? Oh, not that. $84, but only one answer left. Okay. Get the money, you must be correct.
I think so, too.
Okay, Richard, we're going to go with a deer.
A deer, okay. Get you $84 if it's there, Lindsay. If not, Jennifer gets the money. A deer! You got it. Six.
Monkey.
Wow. 157-91. Let's go. One 100 people surveyed, top five answers on the board. Here's the question. Name something sometimes packed in a suitcase that... No coming back now. Name something sometimes packed in a suitcase that might leak all over your clothes. Yes.
Perfume.
Perfume. Play or pass?
Play, Richard.
And just in case you become the champs, I want you to get proficient at this. Show me a minute. Up. Forward. Whack. She did the sneaky. She came up under here and then went, boom. Gonna end up with no nails. Gonna play. You did well, but I don't want you to hurt your fingers there. All right, something's sometimes packed in a suitcase that might leak all over your clothes, yeah?
Shaving cream.
Shaving cream. Not that. First strike. Lindsay.
How about some type of medicine? Cough syrup.
All right. Cough syrup. That's right. Oh.
Lotion.
Maybe. Okay, you need. Is that all right? Okay. Lotion. You got it, Tom. All lotion, oil, and cream. All right.
How about makeup?
All right. Makeup. Yeah. Now we're ready, Maureen.
I think maybe you might have a drink in there.
Okay. Need any particular one? Well, they're from Utah, you know. Drink! Yeah! Okay.
Well, if you have liquor, maybe you got some food.
Okay. I hate it when it leaks over your clothes. Food! Not there. $76 waiting to be taken. Number two is
Shampoo. Shampoo. Toothpaste.
Something sometimes packed in a suitcase that might leak all over your clothes.
Shampoo.
It's you the money, big lead. If it's there, if not, evens the game up. Shampoo! Yeah, you got it. 33-91, here we go. Come on. Come on, Jane. Dollar values are doubled. 100 people surveyed. Top five answers on the board. Here's the question. Name a kind of recreation that goes on in a home recreation room.
Pool.
Play or pass it. Walk it over.
We'll play, Richard.
We'll play. Well done. Kind of recreation that goes on in a home recreation room.
How about ping pong?
Ping pong.
Let's try a game of chess.
Okay. Chess. Not there. That's a good answer. Did not make her survey.
How about an air hockey. Isn't that a game?
Okay, all right. Air hockey?
No. Shuffleboard?
Let's see. Good. If it's there, okay, and if not, third strike. Shuffleboard, please. Oh. It's not that.
Darts.
Cards.
Darts.
Cards.
Darts.
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 Darts. Boy, there's enough there. You'll keep your title. If not, the game goes on. Dark. Boy, a lot of good answers got strikes there. They really did. Great. Cards. Four.
Dancing.
Five.
Watching TV.
265-233. Let's go. Come on, Angel. Dollar values are tripled. 100 people surveyed. Top four answers on the board. Here's the question. Name a shape Christmas cookies come in.
Yeah.
Christmas tree.
Tree. Christmas tree. Player pass.
We're going to play, Richard.
Play. All right. Please listen carefully, because I can only read this one time to you. I get to you, got 3 seconds to answer. It's not that hard. Name a shape. Christmas cookies come in. 3 seconds.
A star.
A star for Kathy. Yeah. 3 seconds, Shelly.
A bell.
A bell. 3 seconds, Noreen.
Santa Claus.
If Santa's there, you will play for $5,000. Ho, ho, ho! I think we had 3 days and never won that much money. You did it in one. All right. Little dollars, you got $233 plus $5,640. Happy holidays.
Thank you.
I hope you had a nice time. Good people.
Thank you.
Happy holidays. John, Barbara Bird, I want to know who you're at. Happy Christmas. We'll play two people. One. First, all right, Kathy and Shelley playing for $5,000 right after we watch this. Good luck.
Thank you.
15 seconds, please. Tell me approximately how much you spend on your mother's Christmas gift.
$25.
Someone who needs a telephone for their job.
A businessman.
Something you adjust on a television.
The contrast.
A comic book character.
Superman.
A state with palm trees.
Florida.
Tell me approximately how much... What?
Sorry, could we have a more specific businessman?
Oh, what type of businessman?
Yeah.
Okay.
An executive. Is that more specific?
What kind of business?
What business?
A banker.
A banker. Okay. Do you need us to wait? Or is there a penalty, you know, for an early... Tell me approximately how much you spend on your mother's Christmas gift. You said $25. You're a nice daughter. Survey said. Someone who needs a telephone for their job. It's the banker to tell you you haven't got the loan. Survey. Yeah. I know. I've heard from them. Something you adjust on a television. You said a contrast. Survey said. Quite a contrast between that and the banker, I thought. A comic book character, Superman. Survey. There you go. State with palm trees, Florida. Survey said. Oh, that's a great score. 50, you got 124. That's good. We're out looking for Shelley. Here she comes.
Oh.
All we need is 76 points, and you have $5,000.
Thank you.
Wish you luck. Please remind everyone the answers Kathy gave us. 20 seconds on the clock, please. Tell me approximately how much you spend on your mother's Christmas gift.
$20.
Someone who needs a telephone for their job.
A secretary.
Something you adjust on a television.
The vertical.
A comic book character.
Superman.
Try again.
Pass.
A state with palm trees.
California.
A comic book character. Here we go. Approximately how much you spend on your mother's Christmas gift. $25 was the number one answer. You said $20. Survey said. What's someone who needs a telephone for their job, and you said a secretary. We need 51 points. That was the number one answer. Survey said. Something you adjust on the television. Volume was number one. Yeah. It's easy now.
Yeah.
You said the vertical, did you?
Right.
All right. We need 24 points for $5,000. Survey said.
Oh.
Five. Comic book character Superman was number one. You. Old Superman, I hate that, dear. Oh, all right. You're going to stick a little Lulu in there? All right with me.
With the zero?
I hope not.
Me
after
too.
Stopping us like that. You said little Lulu, part two.
She's kind of cute.
She is kind of cute. We've left it a little off because we don't want to be, you know, nasty about it. Need 19 points. Survey said.
Oh, that's better.
That could be the difference between the money and going out with Superman. State with palm trees. Florida, number one. You said California. 17 points. $5,000. Survey said. Four guards to pull Shelly off my neck. One of them looked like little Lulu. What a nice surprise for Christmas.
Very nice.
Look at that.
Yeah.
Little tears of happiness. You're beautiful. We love you. Happy holidays. I hope Santa's nice to you. See you here on the Feud. Bye.
Speaking for Family Feud, a Mark Goodson television production. It's time for the Family Feud, introducing the Page family, ready for action. And the Cheek family, on your marks. Let's start the Family Feud. Star of Family Feud, Richard Dawson.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, and happy holidays to you. Hung my stocking up last night. Kind of nice. I got a summons from the health people. So I've got to answer that the 1st of January. It's very depressing. The champs, though, we're here. And they're delightful. The Pages. Give me a big welcome. How are you?
Good. Very good.
How much did you win on Christmas Eve?
Well, we won, Richard, $5,550.
All right.
Yes, it was.
Let me meet all your family, please.
Okay. This is my sister, Kathy.
Hi, Kathy.
And then my sister, Shelly.
Hi, Richard.
My angel.
My mother, Noreen.
Hello, darling.
And my father, Jay.
Richard. Charge the lollipop. Give him a big welcome. You got a song for me?
Yes, we do, Richard. We got a little holiday special we'd like to sing to you.
Okay.
Boom, boom, boom.
Oh, Richard Dawson, you're lots of fun with everyone. Hey, hey, Richard Dawson, in everything you do, with the ladies and the miss, boy, do you know how to kiss. Hey, hey, Richard Dawson, we love you.
Thank you. Now, how did you rehearse? They're all from out of state.
Well, we have a very big phone bill that we practice on.
All right. Four of them are from out of state. He's in California. It cost him about $800 to rehearse that song. I loved it. It was very nice. Thank you.
Okay.
But the Cheek family are here to challenge you. Give them a welcome.
Okay.
Christmas. Let me meet your family.
Next to me, I have my dad, Bill.
How are you, Bill?
My mom, Joella.
Hello, Richard.
My
love.
My brother, Marklin.
Merry Christmas, Richard.
Merry Christmas.
And his wife, Becky.
Hello, Becky. Hey. Give him a big Christmas welcome.
We brought a little Christmas gift for you, since you wear little silk scarves.
Oh, how snazzy. I could wear one of those, couldn't I? I could wear that one.
Sure, sure.
Pop it. Ryan Higby will go crazy. Ryan is my gentleman who gets all my wardrobe, and he'll be downstairs saying, "That does not go with yellow." It does, and I love it. Thank you.
Thank you all.
Take this. Ready to play?
Yep.
We're going to play the Feud. Let's go. Yeah. 100 people surveyed. Top 5 answers on the board. You got to try and get the most popular answer. Here's the question. Name a predictable Christmas gift for Dad.
A tie.
A tie? Number one. Play or pass?
Richard, we're going to play.
Gonna play, my love. Okay. Merry, merry.
Thank you.
Predictable Christmas gift for Dad.
A shirt.
Shirt! Good answer. Yeah! Yeah. My co-star. How you doing?
Fine, thank you.
Okay.
How about socks?
Okay. Socks, please. Yeah. I get that. Hey, darling. What would you say?
I'd say a wallet.
A wallet, please. Oh, well, they never give you the good ones. They give you socks. I like wallets. Good to see you. Take a lucky lollipop, Jim.
Oh.
The other one was worth $5,000. This could be worth the
same. Hang on tight. Bet, right?
Predictable Christmas gift for Dad.
Handkerchief.
Henke! You didn't think this was predictable, did you? And they?
Well, Richard, I'm going to go with a cologne set.
Okay. Cologne! Yeah! Well done.
How about a watch?
Ooh, okay. Wish my boys had been a little more predictable. A watch! No. $92. Sweet Marie and family, come on down here and grab that money if you can.
Belt.
A belt.
Tie clip.
We'll say belt.
A belt. All right, well, if it's there, you get the $92. If not, Lindsay gets there. Belt. Five. Slippers. All right. George, you weren't upset, were you? The belt was set. Georgia gave me a belt for Christmas. In fact, we had a couple of belts, didn't we? Be back right after that. $92, nothing. Come on, Bill, let's change. Happy? 100 people survey. Top 7 answers on the board. Here's the question. Name something without which Christmas would not be Christmas. Yes, sir.
Santa Claus.
Santa.
Good answer, Dad.
Yeah. Come on, 4 answers will beat it.
Christmas tree.
Christmas tree. Play or pass, talk it over.
We'll play.
Gonna play, Bill. All right. Name something without which Christmas would not be Christmas.
How about Christmas carols?
Christmas carol. Yeah.
Good. How about something religious like Christ Child?
Okay. Christ Child? Good. You think it's going? Okay.
Presents.
Presents, all right. Good. Presents? Yeah.
Well, Richard, when I was small, I wanted to look into my stocking. I'll say a stocking.
With a stocking, there wouldn't be Christmas. Stocking? No. Oh. Something that which Christmas wouldn't be Christmas.
Mistletoe.
Oh. Mistletoe. Oh. We don't have that any on our set either, do we?
Oh.
We used to have that.
Let's see. How about goodies? Candies and goodies? I love goodies.
Goodies. I like goodies. Goodies!
Oh.
So, 2 answers unrevealed, sweet Marie.
What do you want?
Name something without which Christmas would not be Christmas.
Family. Okay, we'll say family.
Yeah, I think that. If it's there, nice even game, if not a big lead. Family! You got We must find out where we do these surveys. Well, when Jesus has bottom billing, we've got to think this over. We'll be back right after this. +92, +78. Here we go. Come on. Merry Christmas.
Thank you.
Nice to see you. 100 people surveyed. Top 8 answers on the board. Here's the question. Besides your family, name someone who automatically gets a Christmas gift every year.
Teacher.
The teacher. Yeah, 3 answers will beat that.
How about a friend?
A friend. Let it pass.
Good time.
Besides your family, someone who automatically gets a Christmas gift every year.
A boyfriend.
Well, we got all friends up there.
Oh,
no?
That's all?
Well, hold. Fiance, you mean?
Yeah.
Gotcha. Fiance!
Yeah!
Jay.
The postman.
The postman. That's right. Postman! Good. Jay's a good player. Henze. Who gets automatically gets a Christmas gift apart from your family every year?
How about the paper boy?
Uh-huh.
Oh, good answer.
I do that to save me going on the roof for the paper boy. Yeah.
Your boss.
Boss. Yeah. Good answer. Boss.
I don't give mine, but how about a clergyman?
All right.
Is that okay?
Sure.
All right.
I know they'd love it.
Okay.
Clergy. You better start giving one.
Yeah, I know this year.
All right, Lori.
How about the secretary?
Okay. Yeah. That's there. You got it all. If not, first strike. Secretary. Never mind. Let's get it. Jay.
Most people don't give one, but I give one to the garbage man.
I do, too.
Okay.
Yeah. And why not? I think it's a goodie. The garbage man. No. I swear I do, Jay, and I think you should, because that's not a great job, and also, they tend not to pick it up.
How about the family doctor?
Dr. Woo-woo. If it's there, you got it all. If not, third strike. The family doctor. No! $93. One answer unrevealed.
Charity, Toys for Tots.
Okay.
Besides your family, name someone who automatically gets a Christmas gift every year.
Well, we give to charity.
You don't? Okay, you don't need a particular charity? All right. It's good, and I hope it's there for you. If it is, you get the $93, Marie, and if not, Lindsay will get it. Charity! Yeah, Jim Neighbors. 185, 78. Here we go. Come on. Nice. 100 people surveyed. Top 6 answers on the board. Here's the question. Name one of Santa's reindeer.
Dasher.
Pardon?
Dasher.
Dasher. 3 answers will beat it.
Rudolph.
Rudolph.
We're gonna play, Richard.
Okay. Oh, I thought I was never gonna get over to meet your lady, but now I can do it. Hello. Hi. Merry Christmas.
Thank you.
Take a lucky lollipop.
Okay.
Bingo! $100
lollipop. Well done. Now give me one of Santa's reindeer, please.
Prancer.
Prancer? Yeah. Three.
How about Dancer?
Oh, no, he's not there. Dasher was there. Dancer! Well, you got it. 2 left, that's all. Bill?
Blitzen.
Blitzen!
Good answer.
Here's Blitzen.
I hope it's Donder.
All right. Donder! You got it. this game. 185-173. Let's go. Come on. Jay and Becky. Oh. This is a great way to play a Christmas game. Dollar values are doubled. 100 people surveyed. Top four answers on the board. Here is the question. Who wrote War and Peace?
Who was that?
Tolstoy.
I just wondered. That's been bugging me for years. You know, have you ever had one of those blocks when you can't? I said, I'll find out before this show's over. Thank you. Jot it down so I don't forget it again. Tolstoy. All right. Here's the question. He's so good. He did it. He's so good. All right, here we go. Name something on which people hang Christmas decorations at home.
Yeah. The chimney.
The chimney. One answer will be the
tree. Guess.
The tree, said my friend Tolstoy.
Yeah.
Something on which people hang Christmas decorations at home.
How about the front door?
Front door.
Wall.
All right. Wall? No. Shelley.
The window?
Let's see. The window. Yeah! 379-173. Let's go. Dollar values are tripled. 100 people surveyed. Top four answers on the board. Here's the question. Of all the beautiful Christmas songs, which has been the biggest seller? Yes.
Silent Night?
Silent Night? One answer will beat it.
How about I'm Dreaming of a White Christmas?
Bing Crosby's White Christmas? Got control. What will you do?
We will play.
All right. I'll read this once. When I get to you, you have 3 seconds to answer it. I can't repeat it. Here it is. Of all the beautiful Christmas songs, which has been the biggest seller? 3 seconds, Bill.
Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer.
I bet you got it there. Rudolph! Yes. 3 seconds, y'all.
The First Noel.
Is there. You're the champs. The First Noel? No. 3 seconds.
Jingle bells, jingle bells.
Aha. If it's there, you're going to play for the big money. Jingle bells. It was a great game. That really was. They really were. We're two great families, and I couldn't think of a nicer way to spend Christmas Day than being with two nice families like yourself. $379 plus $5,550. Thank you for being here. And the song made it even better than ever. Happy holidays. Happy. Very special. Coldplay. Two people. Come on. Who's first?
Yes, sir.
All right, Bill's going off. Martin and Bill playing for the money right after we watch this. Win the money, champ.
All right.
15 seconds, please. Tell me how long it usually takes you to break your New Year's resolutions.
1 month.
A farm animal that people have as a pet.
A rabbit.
One thing you add to tomato juice.
Vodka.
Something with an adhesive on it.
I'm sorry?
Something with an adhesive on it.
Pass.
A state with famous colleges.
Boston, Massachusetts.
Massachusetts.
Right. He didn't
comprehend that. I'm going to ask him.
Adhesive?
Do you know what an adhesive is? Something that sticks?
Oh, adhesive.
Adhesive, yeah, do you know?
Sorry.
All right, give me an answer. Something with an adhesive on it. What is it?
With adhesive. Glue.
glue is adhesive.
All right. Elmer's. Yeah. Turn around. Oh, well, that'll work.
I couldn't hear him.
How long it usually takes you to break your New Year's resolutions? You said a month, and I'm proud of you. Survey said 24. Do you really last a month?
No.
No, I never do. Farm animal people have as a pet, a bunny rabbit. Survey 5. One thing you add to tomato juice. You hesitated and then said vodka. The front row's eyes all lit up. Survey 7. Something with an adhesive on it, and you said glue. That isn't adhesive. Survey said. State with famous colleges, you said Massachusetts. Survey said. 21. If it's over, Sophia can be done.
Okay.
All right. We're looking for Bill. Here it comes. Come on, Bill. Want to win the money? You're going to do it, aren't you?
Yes, sir.
Please remind everyone the answers Margaret gave us. 20 seconds on the clock, please. Step over just a little bit. There you go. Tell me how long it usually takes you to break your New Year's resolutions.
2 days.
A farm animal that people have as a pet.
A horse.
One thing you add to tomato juice.
Lemon juice.
Something with an adhesive on it.
Band-Aid.
A state with famous colleges.
It's famous what?
Famous colleges.
Massachusetts.
Try again.
Texas.
Turn around. You both said Massachusetts. Is that what you studied? No? How long it usually takes you to break your New Year's resolutions? A week was the number one answer. You said 2 days. Survey said, he's like me. He tells the truth. Farm animal people have as a pet. You said a horse. Number one.
On.
Survey. One thing you add to tomato juice. Now, vodka was number one. If I were to drink and I put lemon juice in it, and that's what you said. Survey said 9. Something with an adhesive on it. You said a Band-Aid. It was number one. Survey. We're not going to throw you out in the cold, you know. Even if you don't win it, you're still the champs. State with famous colleges. California, much to my surprise, is number one. You said Texas. We need 34 points for the money. Survey said 5. You got 171, $5 every point, total of $855. We will return. If you go to a college in California, I didn't mean to be critical. Love ya. See you here on the Feud.
Speaking for Family Feud, a Mark Goodson television production.